Good clamp management is paramount. We spent a lot of time, money, and effort bringing this silage into the clamp. Making sure that you look after that silage once it's in there will result in better returns, better profitability, and better animal performance. So when you're bringing the silage into the pit with the trailers, please ensure that you are tipping onto a clean area so that you're not bringing soil into the clamp. If you can ensure that the tractor and the trailer tires are clean, as well as the machine that's taking the silage into the pit, that will ensure that you don't get contamination of soil. Bringing soil into the pit will reduce the quality of fermentation and increase the level of butyric acid, which is not what we're trying to achieve. When you come to actually make your silage, it's really important that you are there to manage the whole process. When you bring the silage into the pit, try and keep it in nice, simple, straightforward layers, no more than 15 centimeters at a time. That will help consolidation. Consolidation is absolutely key. You make sure you exclude your oxygen and you get a much better fermentation process. When making the silage, please also ensure that you check your chop length. Chop length can have a big, big impact on how much compaction you can get into your silage. The more compaction you have, the less air is in the clamp. Less air means less mold, less yeasts. We would recommend that you use a silage inoculant in nearly every situation that you can with your forages. The benefits far outweigh the investment that you're putting into that inoculant. Once you open your silage clamp, we want to minimise losses. And one of the best ways of doing that is making sure that you get across the face quickly. An ideal goal would be to make sure you go across the face of a silage pit within a week and using a shear grab to prevent oxygen getting into the silage.
Effective sheeting of the clamp is really important. What we're trying to do is create a completely anaerobic environment. If we look at this clamp, there's actually three sheets being used. Last year's sheet, a new black sheet, and then we've got our cling film or our oxygen barrier being used here, and that's essential. We also look towards the side walls and we've got side sheeting being used. Quite often what we do here is last year's top sheet can then be used as the side sheet for the walls, so we're not wasting any plastic. So in an ideal world, we would have lots of clamp space on farms and the ability to go between different forages as and when. But we all know that this isn't farming simulator and we're working in the real world. So if you're working with high yielding herds and you really need into forages quite quickly, there is products available where we can ensail and open again within 7 days to allow that feed out, to allow that balanced diet to continue. So the consequences of poor clamp management is moldy forage. If our management starts to slip at the most important time when we're trying to preserve that winter feed, it's just going to end up costing money. We can also look at this from a cow health point of view in terms of putting this into the ruminant diet. There is the issue then of mycotoxins, and then we probably may have to feed another feed additive to try and mitigate what has occurred. This forage hasn't been consolidated. It has allowed oxygen in, and there's only two places that we want reduced oxygen. One is in the clamp, and the other one is in the actual ruminant. So we're striving here for an anaerobic environment.